This video is on the disjoint set, or union find data structure. It doesn't have too many prerequisites, but you should at least know the data structure basics like linked lists, dynamic arrays, and trees. This might be my favorite data structure. The code is simple enough to use pseudocode throughout the video, yet the final analysis is too complex to cover here. Best of all, the structure itself seems simple enough to develop, even if you have like a regular sized brain. This will be part of my You're Not a Freaking Moron series, so I will walk down a plausible path to create the data structure from scratch, and unsurprisingly, at no point in time will I look like a genius. The data structure needs the ability to create sets with one element each, to find out what set any element is in, and to combine two sets into one. That's it. It doesn't do much, but it does it very well. First, come up with any way to solve the problem. You can use a dynamic array. I made mine big enough that it won't need to resize. If you want to make some new set with some object, just stick it into your array along with a unique set ID for it. If you want to find out if object B is in the same set as object E, you walk through the set to find E, walk through the set to find B, and if they don't have the same ID, they aren't in the same set. If they are in different sets, to take their union, walk through the entire array, changing all the objects with E's ID to have B's ID. Really simple, really slow. Adding an item takes average constant time, but find and union can take time N if there are N items, and you have to come up with unique IDs. That's not too hard, but why not just use the objects themselves? That's easy. That's why I named my dog, dog. Each object is distinct and sets are distinct. So if each set has one object that it uses as its representative, that works. Of course, you aren't copying the object. You're keeping a reference to it. So the array only needs to hold two references for each item in any of the sets. How can we speed that up? There are a few things you can do, but it also depends on what you're putting into the set. Are they objects that you can mess around with? Like, can you store references in the objects? For this data structure, the assumption is that you can. This won't be a black box data structure like a linked list or array list. You can use those without having direct access to the internals of whatever you're storing. Here, we will modify the objects themselves to hold information, like how we might write a variable like discovery status into a vertex of a graph while searching it. Once we have that, we can store a reference to the set representative right in the object itself. The code gets really simple. Find is trivial. We just return the representative from the object in constant time. Union still takes linear time in the entire set of objects, but the code and the other runtimes are great. What can we do to speed up union? It seems pretty wasteful to go through the entire set of all objects to look for those in just one set. We could keep a list for each set and walk through it to update that set when we call union. The list for a set starts with just one item, and when we call union, we append one list to the other. You can use a linked list or a dynamic array. Linked lists will take time proportional to set X's size. Dynamic arrays sometimes take longer when they resize, but on average have the same asymptotic bounds, probably with better constants, even though the linked list append takes only constant time. But now, look at the code. What's the main dynamic array doing for us? We add to it, but never use or look at it. It's a vestigial organ, and we can evolve to get rid of it. The representative is a special object within the list. I'll draw it above the others. You can visualize both versions similarly until you get to a vertex with more than one other member in its set. Then you'd expect the linked list version to have linked list nodes linking sideways to other elements of the set. For the array version, the representative has direct access through the array to each of the other members, but I wouldn't make sideways links. Also, to keep it clean, I'll only draw references in one direction there. Both look a lot like a one-level tree, and both of those strategies are used in different tree implementations to store a list of children. When these animations finish, we see something a bit awkward. When we combine this size 4 set with a size 8 set, we go through the entire size 8 set to fix its representatives. But when Amazon acquired Twitch, it wasn't an even merge. They didn't flip a coin to see who would take over the company as a whole. The big company absorbed the small company. We can do that here too. Let's append the smaller set to the bigger one. Now the data structure starts to look pretty good. I'll just animate the less visually cluttered version. Make set and find still take constant time, and union's time is now proportional to the size of the smaller set. If you think about an object in a set, every time its representative gets changed, the size of the set it's in has to at least double. So if there are n total objects, no object can change its representative more than log n times. For this data structure right now, if there are n objects, n calls to union can't take more than n log n time total for log n average. That's not bad, but we're two observations away from awesome. The first is that this data structure is really proactive. You have 10 things in a set and it merges with a larger set. You run to every one of those 10 things to tell them they need to update. Then, in the array version, you run through the list to append one to another just so that you can proactively update every object's representative the next time. Maybe object K there doesn't even care what set it's in, and you just keep running up to it to tell it that it has a new representative. That's like doing every problem in a textbook so that it's ready to turn in just in case the teacher asks for you to do that problem for homework. You'll know your stuff really well, but it's not the quickest way to do homework. Relax. Be more lazy. Don't tell everyone they have a new representative if they don't ask. When a set merges with another, just update the representative of the smaller set to make it reference the representative of the larger set, and don't worry about the other objects in the set. Now, they don't reference their representative, but they do reference an object closer to their representative. How does that change our code? First, you don't have to walk through the list during the update. You just change one representative. Once you do that, you don't use the lists except for their size. So just store their size. Don't store the lists. Now, each object just has to keep one reference and a size. The set is a tree, but objects don't keep track of their children, only the size of their set. It's like if I know I have two kids, but I don't have any idea who they are, and I don't worry about it because I never look for them to tell them anything anyway. Okay, that sounds kind of bad. Now that representatives aren't all proactively updated, we have to fix find. The set representative knows it's the representative, just like your congressman knows they're your congressman. For anybody else, recursively ask your last known congressman who their congressman is. Finally, because we don't have direct links to our representatives, we use find instead of that direct link. We don't need to store lists now, but what about speed? Union makes two calls to find, but otherwise only takes constant time. But it isn't great for find. The representative can check that it is its own representative in constant time, but other vertices need to walk up that tree to get to the root. Excluding find, union is really fast, but find is slower, and union calls it, so that seems like a bad trade-off. Find isn't terrible. We still do union by size, so the tree height can't be more than log of its size, and the code still looks clean. I coded it recursively instead of using a loop. But the real problem is that before, find took constant time and union was logarithmic, but we can only have n-1 slow calls to union with n items. After that, everything was in one set. Now, we can have lots of slow calls to find, like if we call find on A, it walks up some path to the tree root. Is that bad? It's not great, but we see the real problem if we call find on A again. We repeat the same work. That's not just lazy. It's stupid. We went from being over-diligent, updating every object's representative, even if it didn't care, to not even bothering to record an updated representative, even after we found it. If we're forced to do the work anyway, save it. If your congressman loses their election and you call them to ask them if they're still your representative, they'll be annoyed. If you call them the next day to ask them again, they'll be pissed. To find A's representative, you ask every object on the path to the root what their representative is. Update them all. I wish these were called lazy but not stupid trees, but it's instead known as path compression. So here's my favorite part, where we see how clean recursion can make our code. How do we add path compression to this code? We recursively update the representative or parent, a few characters of code, that's it. Let's take a look at how that runs on the same set of operations. MakeSet looks the same, and we don't see any difference until we call find on a non-root vertex. Any call to find on a non-root will break and reform its link, even if it's to the same node, because if an item isn't the representative, it automatically reassigns a new representative when you call find. There is no order for the children. Remember, in this social dystopia, the parent node doesn't even know who its children are. My animation displays children left to right in order of how recently the links were made, which changes with path compression, but that's an artifact of the animation, not the data structure. But that will explain why, when you call find on F, it changes from being a left child of J to its right child. The data structure has no left or right. Finally, when we call find on a deeper vertex like A, you see its path compress. It keeps the trees from getting tall here. Trees can still get to be logarithmic in depth, but for that to happen, you have to keep taking the union of roots or something near the root. Find takes time proportional to the depth of the node, so those unions are really quick. Basically, to get a find operation that takes log time, you have to first get a whole bunch of unions and finds that are fast, so the average time per operation will be much better than logarithmic. How much better? If you have n objects, the average time per operation will grow strictly asymptotically slower than log star of n. More precisely, it can grow as fast as the inverse Ackermann function, which I won't even try to define here. The Corman text and others use something called union by rank instead of union by size, which has the same asymptotic bounds. If you didn't have path compression, the rank of a set would just be its height. But once you add path compression, keeping track of height can hurt your efficiency. So rank is what the height would have been on the same operations if there was never any path compression. It's easy to track. Someday, I might get to a video on the runtime analysis proof, but just defining the Ackermann function and its inverse is more complex than anything in this video. That video isn't too high on my priority queue, and I know how to be lazy. I'm also told I need to hire a continuity editor, whatever that is. It's probably not too critical.